Hey guys, today you're going to glue on all your body and face details. You are going to need the pieces that you cut out, masking tape, glue, and a pencil. You won't need your tail or your ears, unless you're gluing something inside of them, or your arms, or the back body piece, unless you have like stripes or something and glue in it. So really you're just going to be focusing on the face and your body piece. You're going to get everything kind of out of the way. And the first thing you want to do is actually take a piece of masking tape and put your name on the back. So that way at the end of the day when you put your stuff on the drying rack, you can find it the next day. And you don't have to flip over something that has pieces that just got glued on top of it. Alright. So now you want to do probably the muzzle piece first. And I know that I have sort of like these ragged edges on mine. So to really get my glue nice and smooth and on all those little zigzag areas, I'm actually going to use a craft stick. Instead of my fingers, because if I keep using my fingers, they're going to get super sticky. And they'll get a little sticky anyway. But these sticks will help a lot. I'm just kind of like smoothing the glue out, almost like how you would put like butter on toast. So I'm going to put a little glue to kind of cover the area. And then I'm going to use my stick to just smooth everything out really nice into all the edges. And that's how my pieces will stay glued, like, really nice and smooth. Sometimes I'll actually, like, put the glue on my stick, like I'm going to be, you know, putting butter on toast or, like, mustard on a sandwich, I guess. It would be like a squeezy bottle. But just get all the little edges, unless you want them to flap up. That's you and that's your design. If you want it to flap up, don't put glue on it. If you do want it to be secure, make it done. Consider the order that you're gluing things in. Like I have a little mouthpiece that goes at the bottom of my muzzle, and that should be underneath the muzzle. So I'm just kind of popping that on the back before I place the whole thing on the body piece. So just make sure you're kind of going in like correct layering order for yourself, so that you get everything the way that you designed. So if you drop any of your pieces and get glue on the bottom, like body piece, do not despair. Just keep gluing stuff down. As soon as you have like, you know, whatever had glue on it on the body, just go grab a damp paper towel and just kind of like dab and wipe at that spot. And it should come right off. You'll be fine. So once all your gluing is done, you want to let everything dry. Take that body piece that has your name on it, which is awesome. And now you can just put that on the drying rack to dry for the next day. Make sure you close your glue up tight. You can throw away your gluey craft stick and put all the other little pieces that you want to save for yourself in your pouch so that you're ready for the next day. Bye. Oh, wait a second. If you have any pieces on your like muzzle, like this little mouth here on the bear, or the cat has whiskers, before you glue it down, you want to sew on those details. You can see the nose is already glued on, but if I glued the muzzle part on, it would just be too stiff to sew. So we're going to sew it first. I'm going to take this needle and thread. I'm going to cut two lengths of thread that go fingertip to fingertip. And I'm actually going to put both of those through the needle together. I'm going to line them up, and I'm going to make a knot, or like a series of three knots, at the end. I'm using two strings at the same time so that my, you know, my line that I'm sewing, the line I'm drawing with my needle is thick enough that you actually see it, bold enough, you know, because it's going to have sort of like four strings when it's all put together. I know for some of you guys, the hardest thing is just putting the thread in your needle's eye. So here are some tips. You can cut off the ends to make sure they're really clean and like kind of together before you put them through the eye of the needle. Make sure that you take all of your ends on all the two strings and kind of line them up and make sure that they're nice and smooth and that the eye of the needle is in the center of both strings before you make a knot at the end or your series of three knots so that you have something nice and fat that won't go through the fabric. Now I am going to just kind of like draw on this little mouth shape with the thread directly. I didn't draw anything first. I think that you guys could do that too and kind of freehand it. No, even if it's like a little off, it's still going to be like cute. So I wouldn't worry about it too much in it. So you're just making simple shapes, like I'm making an upside down V on one side. And I actually like to hold it. I don't know, for some reason it's more comfortable for me to hold this piece upside down, so that's what I'm doing. Make sure, like, as you sew, you kind of make yourself the most comfortable so that you can do the best job that you can. And so I'm making one stitch, I'm coming back, hence back stitch. So I come up, I go, make sure, if you need to cut off these little ends on the back, do it. Just give them a nice trim so they're not in your way. So I kind of came through. From the back, I came back in from the front. That's back stitch, right? And I'm just going to keep doing that until I have, you know, the whole mouth done. And I'll just kind of like hold it, you know, if I had it upside down, I'd just like flip it over to see what it looks like from the other side. When you feel good about your muzzle, you're ready to just make a knot on the back and end your stitching. So I'm going to go through a previous stitch, loop around my needle, pull it through to make my knot. You start to get a little bunched up. Just smooth it out. You'll be fine. I'm going to do that two more times. Through, loop it, pull it through. I like to put my thumb over it. I think that keeps it smoother. And then I do one last one. Loop it around. There's my knot. Okay, and now I'm going to just trim it with my scissors, and I'm ready to glue that muzzle onto the body.